Miracles. Both today, the Allen Revival telecast comes to you as a part of a great crusade to reach 1,000,000,000 souls for Christ. It comes to you from the largest tent in the world as a part of a service already in progress. These services are undenominational, interracial, and are for all people of all churches. We invite you to take a front row seat under this tremendous tent. Roll up your denominational barriers and join the thousands in this old-fashioned service. And later, join Reverend A.A. Allen, God's man of faith and power, as he preaches the gospel and prays for the sick.
We're having an old-fashioned Holy Ghost revival meeting. Everybody take a seat. But sitting here at the piano, and sometimes I play the piano, I'm not a pianist, but I enjoy making a joyful noise. And it's joyful and it's noisy, and God loves it. But sitting here a moment ago, God has spoken to me and told me that tonight he's going to perform the miraculous and show millions of people something they've never seen before. How many believe in miracles? How many believe in signs and wonders? How many believe in miracles? May I say this? Our boys don't even know what they're going to televise, and I don't either, but God wants me to read a verse of scripture, and I want to read it quickly to you, and it comes from the second chapter of Hebrews. Here it is. Listen to this. How shall we escape if we neglect so great a salvation, which at the first began to be spoken by the Lord, that's by Jesus, and was confirmed unto us by them that heard him. Listen to this. God also bearing them, that's the ones that heard Jesus preached, they preached the things they heard Jesus preached. And as they that heard Jesus preached, as they preached it, God also confirming the word, that is, they preached it with what? Both with signs and with wonders and with divers miracles and with gifts of the Holy Ghost according to his will. What did God do? They that heard Jesus preach went out and preached also. And as they went forth preaching, God himself, he bore them witness, or he performed mighty signs and wonders and miracles to let the multitudes know that God himself was with that group that preached his word. Right? Now I want to get this established. And in a moment we're going to televise something way out there. I feel it. I don't know where it is, but it's out there. God, as they preached the word, confirmed the word that they preached. And I tell you this, I am preaching the word here. God confirmed it then, both with signs and with wonders and with divers miracles and gifts of the Holy Ghost. Now answer me, did God do it?
Amen.
Did he do it in the New Testament?
Yes.
Did he do it in the dispensation of the church?
Yes.
And I want this truth established. He performed signs and wonders. What is a wonder? Why, a wonder isn't something you see every day. A wonder isn't something that happens in every church service. A wonder is something that causes people to wonder. And if you'd see it every time you go to church, it would cease to be a wonder. It would be a commonplace, everyday occurrence. And do you know that God is still performing wonders? What's that? Something you've never seen before? And something possibly you may never see again? I said if you saw it every time you go to church, it would cease to be a wonder. It would be a commonplace thing. But God in Bible days, and this is after the ascension of Christ, after the church was established. And God, as they preached the word, he confirmed their preaching both with signs and with wonders and with divers miracles. Why? To let the multitudes know that it was not of the devil. It was not of self, but let them know that it was a true doctrine instead of a false doctrine, to let them know, in other words, that God was with them. Now, God did that. in the early church, why shouldn't he do it in his church today? Do you believe that God's still showing people signs and wonders and divers miracles? Now I want to show you the sin of the children of Israel. You find it in the 78th Psalm. And listen, my Bible tells me that they never got into the promised land. Is that right? They failed to make it in. They all died in the desert wilderness. They died out in the bleached sands of unbelief and doubt and modernism. Not because God didn't show them signs. Not because God didn't perform wonders. Not because God didn't perform miracles for them. But because they remembered not. I'm reading it right out of the Bible. Listen to this. It said, and they forgot, this is the 11th verse of Psalm 78. They forgot his works and his wonders that he had showed them. Yea, they spake against God. Listen to this. But for all this, they sin still, and they believe not for his wondrous works. And the 41st verse of the same chapter, that Psalm 78, says, and I quote, how oft did they provoke God in the wilderness? And they grieve him in the desert. Yea, they turn back. What? They're not going to go on. Why aren't you going on? Because they said, God can't do anything more for us. Well, I said, did he ever perform any miracles for you? I said, well, we just about forgot all them. Are you listening? What is it? They provoked God and they turned back and they tempted God and they limited the Holy One of Israel. Now look at the next verse. They remembered not his hand. That's the hand that delivered them from bondage. They remembered not his hand nor the day when he delivered them from the enemy. How he wrought his signs in Egypt and his wonders. That's why they didn't go on. That's why they failed to get to the promised land. That's why they never had the milk and the honey. It's because they never found rest. They remembered not his signs and they forgot his wonders. Skeptics, atheists, and Gnostics by the million along the church claim they're going to heaven, but they'll never get there. Because the only way in the world they can ever get there is by a sign or by a wonder or by a miracle. God set the children of Israel free by a miracle. The shoes on their feet wore for 40 long years, never wore out. The shoes grew with the feet. They drank miracle water because God caused water to spurt out of a rock when they obeyed God. They ate miracle bread. They didn't even bake it. They found it on the ground every morning. It was angels' food delivered by angels every day at daybreak. And every night they had quail to eat because according to the 78th Psalm, God rained it down from heaven as sand upon the seashore. There was a wall of water on either side of them, a miracle, a sign, a wonder that God was with them. Underneath their feet was a wonder and a miracle. It's a wonder when shoes wear for 40 years and never wax old. It's a wonder when you find water squirting out of a rock at the word of somebody. It's a wonder when you wake up every morning and find light bread or angels' food all over the ground delivered by God. It's a wonder when meat just rains down from heaven. It's a wonder when all night long there's a light over your head in the form of a mighty cloud that flames a mighty flame. It's a wonder when all day long over you there is a sign and there is a wonder, a cloud to let you know that God was there. And listen, every step of the journey, there was a wonder, there was a sign, there was a miracle, a wonder under their feet. They wondered if that wall of water that stood on either side of them, 4 miles high and 20 miles across. It was a wonder when the rock burst open and God gave them water to drink. It was a wonder when they found angels' food on the ground every morning coming from heaven. It was a wonder when the quails came down from heaven every night. My God, it was a wonder that cloud over their head that caught on fire at night. God's always let signs, wonders, and miracles appear and take place in the congregation of the righteous. They that believe in the miraculous to let you know that God is present, that God is in the midst of his people. God told me tonight while I was praying with me, just a moment. And I want every one of you aloud, read the sign over my head. But before you do, I want to make this comment. It's biblical and it's scriptural that God today performs miracles. In 1 Corinthians 12:28, the Bible declares that he placed some in the church. First apostles, secondary prophets, thirdly teachers. I'm quoting Bible. After that, what? Say it out loud. Say it again. After that, miracles then gifts of healing. And I'm not saying that I'm a miracle worker, but the miracle worker is under this big white tent. How many feel his presence today? Do you believe that he's been here night after night and day after day? Why do you think people fly in here from all parts of the country, coming on Greyhound buses or getting an automobile or walk? But they are coming. There's people here from all over the nation under this tent to enjoy the presence of God and God's blessing and God's power. And I want you to read with me in a moment this sign over your head. I'm not a healer. No one has ever heard me say I've ever healed the sick, the diseased, or the afflicted, but the healer is here. The miracle worker is here. I believe that God has placed in the church a supernatural gift, and that gift is healing. That gift is miracle, not miracles. Not only confined to these two, but God has placed 9 supernatural gifts in the church. God has placed the gift of faith, the gift of prophecy, the gift of wisdom and knowledge. Why, somebody said, Brother Allen, we don't only God can give you. And I'm talking of a supernatural gift given by a supernatural God who is all power in heavens and in earth and can do all things. So no one has ever heard me say I'm a healer, but I declare this, Christ is in me. 2 Corinthians 2:16 said, I will move in them and I will walk in them. And that's Christ moving in us and Christ walking in us. The Apostle Paul says, Christ in me, he doeth the works. Is that true? So Paul wasn't doing the works. He declared that it was Jesus in him. How many of you know this afternoon the Spirit of the Lord dwells in you? Jesus is with you. He is in you, and the Spirit of the Lord is in you. Know you not that you are temples of the living God? And the Spirit of the Lord, it dwelleth in you. So we have Christ in us. And Paul said, he doeth the works. I'm not healing the sick. A little lady came and she said, I want you to heal me. Well, I said, lady, you've come to the wrong place. Oh, she said, but you healed one of my neighbors last night. Well, I said, I never did heal him. I said, oh, yes, you did. Said, they took her down there in a wheelchair, and she came walking home. Said, it's the first time she's walked in 17 years. I said, I didn't heal her. Said, oh, yes. And said, I want you to give me, what was it? Oh, she said, I want you to give me a treatment. I said, now I know you've come to the wrong place. Because I said, I have never given anyone a treatment, and I have no treatments to give. But she said, you treated the woman last night. I said, honey, that was Jesus gave her treatment. That was Jesus that healed her. And Jesus is the healer. He's the miracle worker. I want you to quote with me and read this verse as I point my finger to it. It says,
no.
Is with us, and this is the reason why the lame walk and the deaf hear, blind eyes see out of obscurity and out of darkness, and dumb tongues sing again the praises of God. Raise your hands, everybody, and we're going to ask God today to prove to our TV audience, to all who view this telecast, that God is with us by the miracles he performs. Raise your hands and say, Jesus, I believe thou art here, and I believe that thou, O
miraculous things for your glory and for the upbuilding of your kingdom. Bring me that first little lady on the wheelchair. If every one of you in these wheelchairs this afternoon will believe God, God will heal you. Find a seat, everyone. Yes, God. Bless this precious little woman. She's been sick for years. Bless her, God. This your mother?
This is my mother.
Is God going to do something for her?
I believe he will.
You believe he will? He did what?
He has promised it
he
in his word.
She's had a 5-pound tumor on the end of her hip bone. Been bedfast for 4 months. She's had this thing for 2 years. You believe God will do something?
Amen.
What do you believe he'll do? You can stand
up. I believe he's going to make me whole.
Mm-hmm. This afternoon.
From the top of my head to the bottom of my feet.
From your head to your feet.
Amen.
Jesus is going to make you whole.
Amen. Hallelujah.
How many believe it? Let me pull these steps up here. Yes, God. How many believe he's a miracle worker? I want you to read this sign with me one more time. I want all of our friends there in your home. Read it with me. It will do something to your heart. It'll do something to your faith. It'll do something to your spirit. You there in your home, just read it out loud as our camera just spans it. Read it with me again. No. Out loud.
No.
To the this is evidence enough in itself that the devil can't perform miracles. Because a house divided against itself cannot stand. Do you know back in the days of Jesus? First, they declared that the sick were not being healed. Why? They said, oh, these people aren't getting healed. But once they met a man who had been blind all of his life. And the following day, they met him in the marketplace. And somebody said, this is the man that was healed yesterday. And you know what that bunch of religious folks said? Oh, they said, that's not him. They said, this is merely a man who looks like him. Oh, somebody jumped up in defense of Christ and his miracle-working ministry, and they said, this is the man. He's been blind all of his life. Said, this is the man. He's healed. They said, ah, that's not him. So that's a man that merely looks like him. See, they're trying to explain this thing away. They don't want to confess that this is the man that got healed. And they said, well, he's of age, why don't you ask him? They were afraid to ask him. But when they inquired why, he said, I'm the man. He said, once I was blind, but now I see. And they all ducked. And here's what they said. They said, we're going to have to confess he got healed. Because there's too many witnesses. So there's too many people that know that this man was blind. And we're going to have to confess he got healed. But I tell you what, let's do. Let's start some propaganda, and let's make it public that it's the devil doing the healing, and then God won't get the glory, and nobody will believe that Jesus is healing the sick. They said, well, he's healed, but the devil healed him. He's casting out devils by the power of Beelzebub. Now listen, people have not changed one iota the last 1900 years. So many people are declaring folk are not being healed. But then when they have to confess they have been healed, when neighbors come home from these kind of meetings, and your loved ones come home and that couldn't walk now are walking, couldn't see now they see, couldn't speak now they speak and couldn't hear, and now they're hearing perfectly, they say, oh well, they did get healed. But many of them are attributing the mighty works of God to the devil. But my Bible says, say it again, no man can do these miracles except God be with him. Isn't that enough? And if Jesus said it to me, that's sufficient. I believe what Jesus said. Are you going to take the word of Jesus or some of these old infidels and skeptics and agnostics and atheists? Whom are you going to believe? Did Jesus say these signs shall follow them that believe? Why, in the 16th chapter of St. Mark, the 17th verse, he said, these signs shall follow them that believe. They shall lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. Right? He said, they shall cast out demons. Who said that? Are you going to take the Lord's word for it? Or are you going to take some of these skeptics and atheists? I'm going to believe what Jesus said. Listen, friend. To me, this old book will do until somebody brings something else by that's better. But down through the years, people have been trying to dig up something better. But I have never found a one yet that's found anything better than God's word. Hallelujah. Heaven and earth may pass away, but the word of God is steadfast and will endure on through the centuries. But this word is going to last forever. It's going to be open at the judgment. And every man's going to be judged according to the things written in this book. And I believe it. Do you? My God, it's sufficiently. And it's sufficient, rather, for all of our needs. Body, soul, mind, and spirit, and financially. Let God do something for you while we pray today. Well, I'm just about to preach a sermon over your wheelchair. Are you ready?
Amen.
For God to work.
Amen.
Let's believe God.
Thank you.
Oh God, hear me now, Jesus. Hear me, Lord. Hear me today. And let the people know that thou art here by the miracles you perform. In the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, 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 yes. Come on, God's limbering it up. Start kicking it. Jump up and down on it. That's it, jump up and down on it. Oh yes, Jesus. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Jump up and down on it. Oh, yes. Everybody shout. She's trying it out. It's working. I said it's working. How's it feel?
It's better. Glory.
Sure it is.
Thank you, Jesus.
Ooh, how many feel the Spirit of the Lord? Everybody stand and raise your hands. Something happened?
Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
You believe God's
healed you? Amen! Hallelujah!
My Jesus! My Lord! There she goes! She's all right. Put your hands up and shout. Just before we call the prayer line, I have written a book. In fact, it was the first book I've ever written. We'll be offering about 50 different books. God's guarantee to heal you. It comes to you in 168 pages, 16 great chapters, which is God's guarantee to heal you perfectly and permanently without the help of medicines or drugs. And this guarantee is backed by all the power of heaven. It's an inspiring faith tonic. It removes every hindrance to faith. It deals a death blow to modernism, and it's a real eye-opener to the skeptic. It answers every question on healing. It's a complete inspirational textbook on healing and on faith. Not just only on healing, but on faith. And I guarantee that if you read these 168 pages, 16 chapters, it's sold across the nation in all of our campaigns for a nominal price. But I'll mail it to you, and you read it this week. And then by next week, by the time we come back in to your home with this telecast, you can have faith that others are having for your own deliverance in your home in writing, guarantee to heal you. That's God's guarantee to heal you. And now, our prayer of faith for the sick and the suffering. Now, I want everyone that has a blue prayer card or a peach-colored prayer card, stand to your feet and form a line to my left. God's going to heal you today. Amen. How many believe in God with me this afternoon? In our prayer line that we have formed, this woman must have a miracle. That man must have a miracle. In fact, many in this line need a miraculous touch, but God's a miracle worker. Amen. This woman has no bone in her leg from here down. Because of an accident, it was crushed and splintered, and they took it out. She says she believed God can put a bone in there. How many believe God will do it? Oh, God. How long has she been like this, brother?
She's been like this since 1958.
1958. And what happened?
Well, we had an automobile accident in 1958. Uh-huh. And she was in the hospital for a year.
For a whole year?
For a whole year. When I got her out of the hospital, she came out on a wheelchair.
I see. Doctors, do you believe God could do something more?
Yes. Yes, I know. I know he's going to do it right now.
Little lady, do you believe God's going to do something for you?
You are my name.
To some of our Spanish friends. She doesn't speak very good English, but she can sure shout in Spanish. Look here now. You believe God's going to do something for you?
Yes, I believe. Oh, my God.
You believe you put a bone in that leg?
Do I believe?
How many believe in shouting? Dear Jesus, oh God, my God, in Jesus' name, oh Jesus, my God, perform a miracle today for the glory of God. Let the Spirit and the power of Almighty God come on this little Spanish woman. Jesus, you are a miracle worker. I'm asking you, Lord, put a bone in this limb. Put a bone in this leg. God, for your glory, in the name of Jesus. My God, grant it in Jesus' name. Right now, Lord, in Jesus' name, grant it, God. Lord, touch this hip. Touch this hip, Jesus. Touch this little woman's hip. Oh, Jesus. Touch her now, God, for your divine power. You're a miracle worker. God, you made this world out of nothing. You made man out of mud. And you can make this woman a new hip bone and put a bone in this limb. Jesus, grant it today. In the name of Jesus. I'll see if she can do something besides shout. Start jumping on her. Amen. Can you talk?
Yes, I talk.
All right, look at me. Open your eyes. I want you to talk now. You just shout all day. I want you to talk to me. We believe in shouting, don't you?
Yes, I believe.
You believe God's done something for you?
Yes.
What do you believe he's done?
My leg.
What's he done?
Put bone.
You think he put a bone in it?
Yes, I think he put bone.
Can you feel it?
I feel it.
You can feel it?
Yes.
You feel it? Is it in there?
Oh, amen. Amen. Huh? Yes, Jesus.
Is it in there?
Amen.
All right, start walking. Ah.
doing all right?
Yes, she's doing.
Is she doing all right?
Yes, she's doing.
Have her come right on back around this way.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Everybody stand to your feet and let's just say, God, I believe you're doing things under this tent. I just believe you're doing something, Jesus. Do you believe God can perform a miracle for you? Do you believe he could? Let's pray for everybody in their homes. You'll have to help that lady. She can't hardly walk. This little woman's been wearing a brace for 5 years. She's in an automobile accident. She's in constant pain without this brace. She takes it off and she just draws over backwards and doubles up. And she has to wear this brace to hold her over. That's why she stands this way. And you've been wearing it how long?
Well, I leave it on sometimes.
Turn around, let me see what it looks like. You see this? Here it is, clear up to her shoulders. See these ribs? Do you see it? And what happens when you take it off?
Well, if I try to do it, then I can't do it.
You just can't do it. No, you just fall over backwards.
I don't fall, but I just...
You just draw over backwards.
Yeah.
And the brace has to hold you up.
Yes.
And you had it on how long?
It's been 5 years since I had the automobile accident.
5 years? Did you try to get some help?
Well, I went to doctors and had x-rays, you know. Mm-hmm.
But you want Jesus to help you?
I know he'll heal me.
Right now?
Yes.
You'd like to be healed?
Sure, I want to be healed.
And if God heals, you can take that thing over and it won't draw you over?
No.
All right. Isn't that sweet? Without this brace, it just draws her over.
And I work it, don't you?
Now, God. Oh, Jesus. I lay hands upon this woman. She's been injured in this automobile accident. God, for your glory. I'm asking you tonight, give her new vertebras. Put new discs in this backbone. Heal her from the top of her head to the bottom of her feet. Lord, let her take this brace off tonight and be made perfectly whole without it. In the name of Jesus, just bend over. Just a stiff. You can't, can you?
No, you can't.
You just can't even bend.
It's too stiff.
Yeah, it's too stiff. You feel God's doing something for you?
I feel I'm healed.
You feel you're healed?
Yes.
I believe it too.
My heart went down. It's not beating hard now.
Your heart did what?
My heart isn't beating hard now.
Was it before?
Yes.
Did you feel the Spirit of the Lord go through you?
Yes, I did.
You believe you're healed?
I know I am.
You know you are?
Yes.
All right, I'll tell you what you do. You slip out here. You can slip out around behind the platform. There's a little place around there where you can... This usher right here, one of the lady ministers, will take you around there. You take that thing off and come back out here.
I'll take all my clothes off.
Well, that won't take you long. We'll wait. How many believe she'll come back without this brace? Take her out to my office. Here's the keys. Lotta, you can go with her. Raise your hands and say, thank you, Jesus. She'll be back in a moment reporting victory. This little woman had an infection in her ears, and since that time, she's had a horrible ringing in her ears, just torments her. You believe God will take it away?
Yeah, the Lord said, the night is my night.
God spoke to you and said, tonight's your night.
Yes, thank
you. So he's going to heal you tonight.
Yes.
How many years you had this?
Oh, I don't know for sure.
Many years?
Yeah, it was about 18.
About 18 years?
Gonna get, not since I was 18.
Since you were 18?
Yeah, but I don't know sure the year anymore.
All right. Father, in the name of Jesus, I place my fingers in these ears, and I command that this ringing and tormenting noise leave these ears, and I command that peace and quietness and stillness come to these ears. As peace came to the troubled waters when Jesus spoke the words. In the name of Jesus, peace. Peace and quiet. Now.
It's all gone.
It's what?
It's gone now.
It's gone now?
Yeah, it's always felt I had something in my ear. Thank you, Jesus.
It's gone.
Yeah.
It's all gone.
Yeah.
Raise your hand. Everybody shout, thank you, Jesus. Isn't Jesus wonderful? He'll do the same thing for you. Here's a little brother that doesn't speak English. He doesn't speak English. He'll have to have someone interpret for him in Spanish. You tell your friend that God's going to heal his ruptured disc tonight.
Dios le va a curar esta noche.
Does he believe it?
Lo creo, yeah.
See?
Yeah.
See?
Yeah.
In constant pain, he can't lift a thing. And how many years? Ten years this
way? 10 years, yeah.
10 years.
10 años que no pueda, que tengo que dejar los trabajos porque cada vez que voy a esto, pues se me
pica. He wants to live tonight.
Los nervios, yeah.
Tell him God's going to give him a new back.
Yes. Dios le va a dar una nueva espalda.
Okay. Yes?
Yes.
See?
Yes.
All right. Stand right there. Now, there's nothing so dangerous or painful as a ruptured disc. That's that little pad of gristle between the bones of the vertebrae in your back. And when one is ruptured, they just grind together and you're in horrible shape. Many times even an operation doesn't help. I'm going to ask God to operate on this man. Hold his coat. Now Jesus, here's a man that can't lift a thing. But you're going to heal this spine tonight. God, I believe you're going to do it. Oh, God, for your glory. In the name, there it is right there. It's a huge knot. Look at that. You see that? Oh, God, in the name of Jesus, I lay hands upon this man, believing that you heal this ruptured disc. Put it in place. Make a new one and put it there, God, for your glory, in the name of Jesus. Grant it, O God, let the power of the Spirit of God fall upon him. In Jesus' name, a new spine and a new disc, in the name of Jesus. Amen. Gracias, El Señor.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Gracias, Señor.
Yes, gracias, El Señor.
Le sirvo a un Dios de poder, y yo sé que el Señor es el que me puede dar la sanidad.
Is it done? Is it done?
Well, yeah.
It's done. He feels it's done.
Yo no me siento nada ahora.
I feel nothing, he said.
He does feel no pain.
No.
He's all right. Bend over. This way. That's it. Clear over. Touch your toes. That's it. Touch your toes. Uno más. That's all right. Now straighten up. Come here, Don. Run on home. Raise your hand and say, thank you, Jesus. Now, this man needs a real miracle. For 13 long years, he's had tuberculosis. He's been operated on 4 times. And they removed half of this lung right here. Half of the right lung is gone. And 9 ribs. How many ribs does a person have? Anybody know? 12 on each side. And they've removed 9 from this side and only leaving 3 ribs on this side. Is that right?
That's right.
What do you want God to do?
I want to give me my rib back and place this lung for me. Why, I have a breathing power once again.
You want breathing power again?
I want breathing power once again, Lord. Give it to me. I know you do it. I can't climb no hill, no stair.
Great hole in this side. Turn right around this way. It's just gone. And half of this lung is gone.
Half of that lung.
Now, what made you believe God could do such a thing?
Well, I don't know he can do it. He can do everything.
He can.
He can. Trust me, promise this, for I know he can. take care of me own. I mean, give it to me. He can let me keep it. Yes, Lord, I know he will.
Yes, I believe he will. How many believe he will?
Yes, Lord. You believe God can give a man, put another lung in there, and put 9 ribs in?
Yes.
Is God a God of miracles?
Yes.
In the 12th chapter of 1 Corinthians, God said he praised some in the church. The 28th verse said, first apostles, secondary prophets, 30 teachers after that miracles. Where? In the church.
Amen.
Then this is the church, at least one of the churches. This is a great church. This is probably the biggest church. Possibly the biggest church in the world. At least it's the biggest tent in the world, and I've never heard of a church being this big. I've never seen anybody building a church that'll seat 20,000 people. This is a part of that great church. And God said in the church he placed the gift of miracles. And I'm going to ask God to let that gift of miracles put in new ribs. And the half of his lung that's been removed, God put it back and let this man breathe again.
Yes, Lord.
Oh, God.
Yes.
Now, God, look at that hole. Oh, God, in the name of Jesus. That hole in his back. Jesus. My God, for your glory. I'm asking you, Lord, because this man would like to climb steps and climb a hill again. But I'm asking for the glory of God. Put this lung back in, God, that's been removed. For these ribs, Lord, that have been cut out. Oh, God, for your glory. In the name of Jesus, my God. Jesus. Right. Wait a minute. Something's happening. Something is happening. This hole is filling up. Yes, it is. In the name of Jesus. It is. This bone's coming back in here. Can you feel something happening?
Yes, feel it tightening up in there.
You can?
Yes. Yes, Lord. I believe I got him back, Father. I believe I got him back, Lord.
You got him back?
I believe I got him back again, Lord. Help me to thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. I think I got him. I got him back once again. I got him back. I got him back. I got him back once again. Yeah. Thank you, Jesus.
What does it feel like?
Oh, it feels different all over.
It does?
Yeah. Feel like I got something in here now.
Yes?
Yes, Lord.
Yes, did Lord. God done something?
Yeah, he did something.
Take a deep breath. Can you breathe better?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Couple sides bigger than the other if they're both the same.
If I didn't know you just prayed for this man, I wouldn't be able to tell there was any difference at all. I can't tell a bit of difference at all in him.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Does anybody here know there was this cut out?
Oh, yeah. I got a few friends around know this cut out. Yes, Lord.
Well, you go tell them that God's done something for you. Let's shout again. Little woman's having a job to walk, but she's walking. You've had a what?
A bone graft.
In your ankle?
Yes, my bone was crushed completely.
Uh-huh. In your ankle?
In my ankle.
And they grafted a bone?
Taking a bone from my hip and put in my ankle.
Uh-huh.
And
what was wrong with your ankle?
It was crushed in an automobile accident.
And it won't heal?
Well, it's still stiff. The doctor said it'll be stiff.
Be stiff all your life?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
What do you think God wants to do?
I know God is going to heal me. Uh-huh. Well, I threw my crutches away yesterday because I know he's going to heal me.
Well, you've been walking on crutches.
I've been walking on crutches for about a year and a half.
Oh, I see. And you threw them away yesterday.
How come you threw them away? I've come down here for you to heal me.
And you've already been partly healed.
Partly healed because I threw those crutches away.
And you don't need them now?
I don't need them anymore. I think God is going to heal me.
I think maybe he's already healed you. When did you get a prayer card?
Yesterday.
When did you throw the crutches away?
Yesterday.
And you've been walking on them a year and a half?
I've been on them a year and a half.
Uh-huh. Well, you still got it in a bandage.
It's in a flexible cast.
Did you have some other kind of a cast on it?
I had a cast on up to my hip at first, and then they taken one down on it.
I see. And you want God to finish the work.
I want him to just heal my soul, because I have two boys to raise, and they're growing up, and I want them to have a mother that can take care of them.
You're not a Christian?
I'm a Christian, but somehow or another I got on the wrong track. But God will turn you back. He'll make you think.
Yes.
He'll make you turn around and think.
God has used this. Let it happen to turn her around and bring her back. God touched this little mother. There are two boys that need a mother to guide them and lead them right. Now I'm asking you tonight that while I pray, you're going to heal this limb and this broken ankle. You're going to finish the work. She throwed her crutches away yesterday, God. We believe you've already started the work. Sit down right there. How many believe God's going to finish the work? Been on crutches a year and a half. Came yesterday and got a prayer card. God spoke to her heart. She threw them away. It could be she's already healed. But I'm going to pray. Oh God, my Father, in the name of Jesus, for the Lord, for this graft and the bone that will not grow back in place they have grafted. This stiff ankle, oh God, in the name of Jesus, heal this limb tonight. Heal this ankle tonight. God, make her completely whole for your glory. Now, God, down to the very soles of these feet, make her whole. I believe you, God, right now. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, God. Jump up. What happened?
I'm here.
Why, sure you are. What happened? Did it limber up?
It's limber.
The pain left?
It's gone.
It's gone?
It's gone.
My God.
It's gone.
Yes, it's gone.
It's gone.
Yes.
It's gone.
This is what the Bible means when it says, shout unto God with a voice of triumph. Everybody stand to your feet and let's glorify the Lord. Let's thank him and praise him. Here's our little friend. He went out to my office and you took that old brace off, didn't you? What did you find?
Oh, it doesn't hurt me.
It don't hurt you. And you're able to stand up straight and it's not pulling you over. And your heart don't bother you?
No.
That's all right. Just keep it in the sack. Everybody raise your hands. Say, thank you, Jesus. Did I tell you God was going to heal her? She's going to take that brace off? Raise your hands to heaven again. Let's sing, I got just what I wanted. From the Lord. I got that spot on it. Now, just a moment. As I pray, let the glory and the power of Almighty God go forth. You said the prayer of a righteous man availeth much. Oh God, heal the sick, heal the suffering, open the ears of the deaf. My God, open the eyes of the blind, cause the lame to leap, cause the lame to walk. Oh God, perform miracle after miracle after miracle, as we leave you now, in Jesus' name. Now, just a moment.
10 years.
And you want God to make you whole?
Yes.
Where is the arthritis?
It's all over my body.
It's all over. How would you like to jump out of this chair and start running for Jesus?
Fine.
Fine. How many believe God can do it? Do you believe God will do it? You come a long way to get healed, didn't you?
Yes. From this morning.
Do you believe God's going to heal your wife?
Yes, sir.
And she's been sick for 17 years.
Yes, sir.
But God's going to make her whole?
Amen.
When?
Now.
Now. He says now. Now listen, lady. When I pray, I'm believing God to do it. Everybody believes God's going to do it, shout amen. Oh, God. Lord, for 17 years she's been in this shape and this condition. Oh, God, I believe you right now, Lord.
Yes, Lord, I believe you.
To undertake that as I touch her,
yes, Lord,
the power of God's going to go through her. Drive this arthritis out of her body. Oh, God, hear my prayer tonight, Jesus. Hear my cry. And God, for your glory, perform a miracle. Jesus, I believe you. Oh, God, you said you shall lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. You said the works I do shall you do also. Greater works you've gone to the Father. Now, Father, in full faith of Calvary's victory and standing on the promise that you can't lie, I lay hands upon this woman. I believe in Jesus. Raise her up. 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 In Jesus' name, start walking. In Jesus' name. Everybody shout. Come on. Shout with me.
Praise God. Praise God.
Amen. Amen.
Praise Him. Praise Him. Praise Him. Praise Him. Praise Him.
Everybody raise your hands and let's praise God. Raise your hands and shout. Come on. Amen. 17 years. Woo! Raise your hands. Come on, let's walk.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
In this week. In this week. Everybody stand to both feet. Raise your hands and praise the Lord. She's a little weak, but God's healed her. Everybody raise your hands and shout. Everybody raise your hands and praise the Lord. Is it done? Do you believe God can do it for you? Oh, let's praise the Lord.
And now for you that have the special peach-colored prayer card. If you'll come to your feet and lie and form a line here, Brother Shambach will assist you to my left. We're going to pray for you as you march over the ramp. We're going to do what we said works. We're going to lay hands on you in Jesus' name, and God's going to heal you tonight if you only believe. How many believe that God's going to do it?
Amen.
If you do, say amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Bless this little woman, Jesus. Bless her, Lord, tonight. Yes, Jesus. God's going to give you an overhaul from your head to your toes.
Oh, gosh.
Do you believe it?
I surely do.
What's your trouble? Arthritis.
Arthritis.
In your spine and in your hips. You're just going to throw them away and run off without them tonight? Yes?
Yes, I am.
Tell the people, I believe tonight I'm going to start running.
I believe tonight I'm going to start running.
This is in your hips.
hold her up there. She's got in her hips and all up and down her spine. She says sometimes it gets worse. Sometimes she can walk a little bit and hobble around, but sometimes she has to use those crutches. Is that right? God's going to do it tonight. How many believe it? You know what I believe? That arthritis is a demon force. I call it a crippling spirit. Are you going to sit there in that wheelchair or lay in that bed or sit in that home? Or are you going to go around with your canes and crutches when God will set you free? Listen to me, friend. Believe God right there. Now, Jesus, I lay my hands on this little woman. In your wonderful name, I curse the devil of arthritis. In the name of Jesus, Lord, remove every bit of it out of this spine. Take every bit of it now out of these hips. In the name of Jesus, remove it, the cause and the very pain. Let this woman be made normal tonight. In the name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus, I command it leave the spine. In the name of Jesus Christ, double your liar. In the name of Jesus, Lord. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, devil, you're a liar. Go on, sister, the devil's a liar. Amen. How many believe the devil's a liar?
Hallelujah.
There's a man that must be led around.
Praise
you, Jesus. They say he's had sugar diabetes for 20 years.
20-some, yes.
And he's been blind for 4 years.
Yes.
You believe God's going to heal him tonight?
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Baba, do you believe God's going to open your eyes?
Right.
No, so you can walk without having to be led around?
That's right.
You believe God's going to do it tonight?
I know he
Amen.
Is.
Oh,
glory.
Oh,
he says, I love him. Here's a man that's been blind for 4 years.
Oh, glory.
I don't mean failing sight. He's blind. God's going to open his eyes.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, thank you, Jesus.
Praise you.
Oh, glory. Thank you, Jesus.
Praise you.
I want to leave this man around here the last 2 days.
Praise
that the moment you touch
thank
me,
Jesus, Lord.
My eyes are going to be open.
Thank you,
yes,
Jesus.
Lord.
Look at that.
Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Lord. Devil, you're a liar.
Amen.
This man is blind because of his sugar diabetes. We're to curse the sugar in Jesus' name. And from the moment the sugar is done, he's going to begin to see.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Many people that are blind from other causes, we prayed for a man some time ago, has eyes blown out in a mine explosion. Felt in this line tonight as a man 7 years ago was in a mine explosion. He's blind for that reason. I believe God's going to give him instant sight. This may be gradual, because we found with sugar diabetes, when the sugar is dead, the sight returns normally and gradually, even as it left. But I have a feeling God tonight is going to do it definitely and instantly as a miracle.
Amen.
How many believe it?
Amen.
Father God.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Jesus.
I claim it for this man.
Yes, Jesus.
Cursed be the sugar demons in this blood.
Thank you, Jesus.
Cursed be the sugar.
Thank you. Glory.
Cursed be the sugar.
Thank you, Jesus.
Cursed be the blindness.
Thank you, Jesus.
Cursed be the darkness.
Yes, Lord.
God, lift the light tonight. Lift the blind. Lift the shades in the cloud. Let these blind eyes see again.
Thank you, Jesus.
Prove to this multitude of people that bow in the heavens.
Thank you.
And that you have never changed. In the name
Jesus.
Of Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
How many believe he's going to see tonight?
Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah.
Now, buddy,
glory.
I'm going to take the handkerchief from your eyes.
Thank you, Jesus.
And you're going to be able to see.
Yes.
Do you believe it?
Amen.
Are you ready?
Amen. Yes.
Then you're going to tell the people what the preacher looks like.
Oh, glory.
Oh, thank you, Jesus.
This man's been in this meeting for 2 days and don't even know what the preacher looks like.
Oh.
How many babies going to see me?
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Praise you, dear blessed Jesus.
Thank you.
In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
Thank you, Jesus.
I command the blind eyes see.
Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Praise you. Turn around and get it.
Oh.
Everybody stand. Preachers.
Oh, hallelujah.
You see him?
I see him.
Yes, he sees. Amen. Listen, I want to tell you something. Shh, listen just a moment. This man's going to pray with me tomorrow. Come here, Brother Shambaugh.
Praise.
Together, God said if any two or three of us would agree, touching anything here on earth, it should be done to our Father in heaven. But just before praying, here's what I want to tell you. These people that have such wonderful, divine, God-given faith are people that sit in the afternoon services and receive the instruction written in this book.
Thank you.
15 great chapters, 168 pages. God's guaranteed to heal you perfectly and permanently without the help of drugs or surgery. Write for it. Read it this week. God says faith cometh by hearing and hearing God's word. Faith arrives in your heart, and when we pray over the telecast next week at this same time, you will have the faith this man had. Write for it. All you have to do is just impose an offering for the support of this great ministry and work. I will be glad to send it to you by return mail and ask for God's guarantee to heal you. The greatest book, a complete inspirational textbook on divine healing. But now, God bless your hearts. I feel that many of you sitting out there saying, God's going to heal me. God's going to heal me. God's going to heal me too.
Amen.
All you have to do, listen, if you're seated and can stand, stand.
Thank you.
Put your hand over on the TV set. It'll sort of give you a contact with this great campaign. And when you touch it, you're going to feel something. Join my hand, brother.
Oh, thank you.
God said if we'd agree together, he would answer prayer.
Jesus.
I'm going to pray for you there, and the two of them here are going to agree with me, and God's going to heal thousands
thank
of you today.
Jesus.
Now, Father.
Oh, God. Thank you, Jesus.
Before we slip out of these homes again today, we're offering a prayer of faith.
Amen.
We agree together. For every man and woman and boy and girl at once in view today shall be healed now. As they reach out by faith and claim the promises of God. Let the Spirit and the power of God go forth. Stretch forth any of God's hand. Heal multitudes there now. Open the eyes of every blind person that would like to approve this telecast today. Take away arthritis and heart trouble, sickness and disease, cancer and tumor and gutter. In Jesus' name.
Thank you, Jesus.
If you've got God's power, raise your hand. Now listen.